Hi, I am Hudson Meeks and I am a developer in the customer engineering team at BMC Software.
This short video covers the performance diagnostics view within the BMC ProactiveNet Performance Management application server. This view provides performance, utilization, and configuration information regarding the ProactiveNet Performance Management application server itself. Before we actually look at the product, let's go over a few key concepts. First of all, the diagnostics data provided in this view should be reviewed periodically during implementations. And it should be done in phases as well. So for example, after you've connected the first 100 monitored servers to the BMC ProactiveNet Performance Management application server, you would want to go back and review the information in the performance diagnostics views. This helps ensure that you do not exceed scalability limitations, and it helps you stay ahead of other issues as well. The kind of information that you will find in the performance diagnostics view includes server process performance metrics such as CPU utilization and other metrics related to the JServer process, the rate process, and other processes. Quantities of monitored objects, user information, install information, and configuration data is included as well. Let's take a look at the product. Okay, so let's log on to this BPPM server. After logging on to the BPPM server as an admin, we will find the diagnostics view, the performance diagnostics view that is, under options and administration. If we scroll all the way to the bottom of the administration tab, you will find performance diagnostics here under the BMC ProactiveNet heading. Click on view, and now we see that the diagnostics information is separated into two major parts. There is an area for performance graphs and a second area for performance diagnostic details. Let's take a look at the graphs first. Here we see a listing of various graphs related to different parts of the operating system and application server that are being monitored. Here at the top, we see a number of different metrics that are being monitored from the operating system, including swap space, system CPU, and total CPU utilization. So this is metrics for the operating system itself. But as we come on down here, we see metrics related to specific processes that are part of the BPPM application server. In this case, the second graph is for the rate process. And we can see real memory used, consumed by the rate process, CPU utilization, and virtual memory utilization as well for the rate process. As we scroll on down, we will see additional graphs for the different processes that are running as part of the application server, and in this case also the database server process as well, because this is a Sybase implementation. Here we have the JServer process, and if we keep scrolling on down, we'll see even more. For example, this ProNet underscore CNTL process is the agent controller, and then we have the local ProactiveNet agent running on the BPPM application server that's doing the self-monitoring for us, shown here. And as we scroll on down, we see the MCell process for event management, the ACell process for the administration cell, and the Sybase ASA and telescope. And that's the last one. Now the thing that we want to look for here is outliers, basically, and all of these parameters are monitored just like any other parameter would be in the BPPM environment. So we can set thresholds and things like that on them, and when they go into an abnormal state, they'll go into alarm for us as well. You'll notice that some of these processes have spikes in CPU utilization and other monitored metrics. For example, the JServer process has a spike every so often, and that's very normal behavior for the way that it processes data. The same is true for the rate process. If we come back up here to rate, you'll see that it's spiking every so often. It has a very normal periodic fluctuation in the way it behaves. If we go to attributes and indicators, we can toggle off virtual memory and real memory and turn on the baselines and look at the baselines for CPU utilization as an example. So I'll just go ahead and click on generate graph here. And now we can see the baselines for the rate process. If we scroll back down all the way to the bottom, you'll notice this spike here that seems to be all by itself for the Sybase and telescope monitor, and this spike is related to bytes per second, as you can see. And that may look like a problem, but in actuality it isn't. If I go and change my date range up here to the top and start with a previous date, let's go all the way back to say March 5th and regenerate that graph and take a look at the graph again, we now see very regular behavior for all of the processes. And when we get all the way down to the side basin telescope, we see that there's another outlier here like we had previously. We see that this outlier occurred on the 11th, and this one occurred on the 18th, exactly 7 days apart. So this is not really a problem. It's an indication of a process that's running on a once-a-week basis, most likely the pruning process that goes in and cleans out old data. Now that we're done looking at the graphs, let's go take a look at the performance diagnostic details. So we'll click on the view for that. And now we see the performance diagnostic details presented in this view. Now notice here at the top, we see some very key metrics. For example, the number of groups and the number of devices being monitored, which relates directly to our scalability for the solution. So those are a couple of items that you're going to want to look at periodically during an implementation to ensure that you don't exceed the limits there, in addition to paying attention to the performance of the behavior of the application server as we saw in the graphs previously. If we scroll on down here, we see a lot of different metrics that are provided here. I won't go over each one. There's some cell information there, meaning information related to the event management cell. Event management cell metric counts, for example, number of CIs that are associated with different types of classes as you see listed there. And cell workload counts. So we see workload information regarding the number of events that have been processed and so forth there. Remote agent details, a listing of the different remote agents that are connected into this BPPM server. Device details, meaning the total number of devices on a remote agent and that are being also monitored within the server, so broken out that way. And as we scroll on down further, we see monitor type details, some useful information there, attribute details as well, KPI details, and scrolling on down past KPI details, we will find some very, very important information from a scalability perspective. And that's basically the total number of KPI attributes, total non-KPI attributes, and most importantly, the total number of attributes overall. So as you can see, this particular server is running in a small type of configuration, meaning it has less than 50,000 attributes that are being monitored. If we scroll on down past this, we see additional information regarding the agent KPI details and how many KPIs and so forth are coming from these different agents that are processing data through the integration service nodes. User details, so if you want to know who's logged in and who all the different users are, we can see who those users are and what their levels of access are, as well as who's actually logged on right now. In this case, we can see that there are two people logged on as administrator from two different boxes. And if we scroll on down further, we see additional detailed information regarding data collection, raw data retention periods, rate data retention period, and so forth. And then further down, there's even more reports on specific information. So for example, if you want to see how many reports are set up in the system and being generated over time, you can click on Show under the report area here and get an understanding of that. And this is an area that we need to pay a little bit of attention to, especially if we're trying to generate a lot of reports out of the BPPM server for basic reporting purposes. That's an area that can have an impact on scalability as well. So this is something that we'd want to take a look at periodically and ensure that we're not generating an unnecessary number of reports. Scrolling on down further, we see additional information related to the installation, as far as the type of system it's installed on, the database information, IP network information and so forth as well. And we can drill down and get even more detail on system information here, as you can see, routing information from a network perspective, and then also TCP/IP connection information. So we're able to come in here and get this kind of data very quickly and readily through the front end without having to go and generate or initiate various types of commands like netstat at the operating system level and so forth. And so that is a very good overview of what's available in the diagnostics, performance diagnostics, that is, that's provided out of the box with the solution, and you don't have to do anything to enable this. This is readily turned on out of the box for you, and you should be monitoring this and paying attention to this information, especially during the different phases of an implementation. That concludes this video. Thank you for watching the video, and thank you for using BMC products.